Go ahead.
I got, I mean, lost for words, right? Everybody was in attendance. But I tell you what, you know, we started the week out, you know, talking about just tapping into the human element of these kids and getting them to get back to enjoying playing football and playing fast and having fun and loving being with each other and taking adversity and learning how, you know, in adversity are great life lessons that if you use it the right way, it can make you strong. You know, kind of what won't kill you will only make you stronger. And those guys did a fine job each day. We got a little bit better each day. We healed a little bit each day. And as we got closer and closer, they locked in more and more and really focused in on the game plan. I thought we executed really well. So obviously they were prepared. And I know we had some things that we got to clean up and different things like that. But just so proud of the way they fought and then to just believe. And just to believe all the way to the end. We talk about doing things to the 4-0s on the clock. Playing to, you know, till they say the game's over. And that's exactly what they did. A little beyond too, right? I think it went beyond the 4-0s. You don't see many of those plays in college football. So I'm my heart goes out to those kids. It's all about them, right? From the very beginning, we said it's all about them. It's about us as mentors and teachers rallying around what we needed to rally around for them. And they came through in the end. So it's awesome.
Yeah. First 5 or 6 plays of the game, you make a goal line stand after losing the 58-0 game. How important was it to not let Duke in the end zone right there?
I think that was key. You know, it was key just to so that they can understand that if you continue just to do what you are told to do, execute and play hard, the plays will be there. Don't try to do anything more than that. Just play hard and the plays will be there. And I think it was a bit of a spark for our football team, you know, that stand, that stop. And it really meant to the guys that, okay, hey, we're here to play. We're here to play. And they did a good job following up from there, you know. I'm just proud of them.
Larry, in the time that you've been here, have you ever seen greater top-to-bottom effort from this team?
No. I mean, there's some games that I thought we really came out and played well. I think just because the adversity and the things even during the game that they had to overcome is what made it that much more sweeter. You know, it's just, we had a lot to deal with, a lot to overcome, and they just kept playing. They never stopped believing, and there's the result.
Larry, your thought, I mean, on that last play with all the laterals, just are there words to describe what you're feeling?
No. It was kind of like, just keep playing. Just keep playing. And I just kept saying to myself, just keep playing. Just keep playing. Keep playing. I know I used kind of joke earlier in the week about it being the playground, you know, about it being kind of like recess. And you know what? How about that? That's what it kind of turned into, right? A kid's game, out playing hard and never stop believing. That's just like the old, what was it called? Hot potato game or whatever you want to call it. However, that's how it kind of worked out, right? I mean, they just kept playing, kept believing. And, you know what, the good thing about it is they were smart enough. There was one time where I think maybe Corn got ready to throw the ball and recognized that the guy wasn't behind him and held it and waited till he got behind him to throw it. I mean, that's stuff that leaves you at a loss for words because you really can't explain it, but just keep playing.
Were there tears shed or what are the emotions like?
All over the place. But that's what you get when we're talking about life and human emotion and real emotion. There was anger. There was frustration, there was tears, there was relief, there was some grief, you know. So it was all there. So I just told them in there, there's so many great life lessons we can carry from this. And we're gonna try to capture every one of them too. We're gonna try to capture every single one of them.
After that last drive where Duke took the lead, what was kind of going through your mind when you'd seen the effort? Did you even for a second think, oh my gosh, these kids are gonna get another blow?
Surprisingly, no. Surprisingly, no. I kind of, you know, it was kind of, we'd actually practiced a play that we didn't have an opportunity on quick six, on kickoff return call. And we thought that was going to be the call. And we kind of said, you know what, this is a last pitch effort, but it's something we've worked on and you got to believe in. So if you can't go in the huddle and call it and don't look like you believe in it. So, okay. Sold it to the tip. I mean, actually didn't work out the way you practiced it, but it worked out. So,
how much had you practiced that?
How much have we practiced that?
That last, yeah. I mean, that was too organized. Come on, Larry. You had to practice it at least once or twice.
I think maybe with that, well, I don't know. Torrance from Nashville and Mark Walton's from Miami, so I don't know when they practice that. I have no idea. I mean, that's something you do when you're in, you know, third grade or fourth grade, and they say seven period of the day is PE. I mean, I don't know.
So they really did that on their own?
Yeah.
Not even the first pass?
What, the first pass? No, the first pass is the initiation of it. And then from there, it's kind of like, okay, play ball.
ESPN reported that there were 8 laterals in 46 seconds.
Really? Wow. I mean, I'll have a chance to watch it. And I know I watched it live, but I really wasn't counting the laterals. I was just making sure every time it was a lateral. That was just behind the line.
Talk about the backup quarterback tonight.
Yeah, we've already got this. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. I mean, he did an awesome job of preparing. You know, if he goes out, goes to Brad, too. Brad, you know, even though he wasn't able to make the trip, he met with him, he worked with him, and, you know, gave him advice and talked to him. And Coach Coley, you know, did a phenomenal job with the kid. But Malik's a winner. He was a winner in high school, you know. He won a lot of football games in the high school program. So it was important that we got him started early, gave him some confidence early, and then he made some really good deep ball throws. You know, he really did, and connected on them. And I think the players around him raised their level of play a little bit around him to support him. And we were able to get our run game going. You know, and that always takes some of the pressure off the quarterback, especially in young quarterback.
How much emotional picking up did you have to do with him after the Clemson game just to get ready?
He's a competitor. So, you know, all these kids are. Obviously, you know, we had to do some picking up, you know, all around the team. But I think, I mean, as a coach, aren't you constantly? That's what you're constantly doing. You're constantly, you know, picking up, cleaning up, fixing up, patching up, you know, whatever you got to do to make sure you put a good product on the field the next week. So, I mean, that's just part of it. That's part of the deal. And yeah, everybody was a little hurt after that. Everybody was a little hurt, but that's the response you want.
Larry, you talked about reaching every player. You know, do you feel like you reached them maybe more than you had anticipated?
Yeah, a little bit. I'll be honest with you, a little bit. I think they played inspired. You know, they played like, you know, they really wanted to. Every one of them really wanted to come out and play with them. And that's the biggest piece of it. And I thought if we did a good job this week, kind of capturing their hearts, we you know, we get them in the right place, the right frame of mind. They were really kind of loose, which, you know, as a coach, you kind of go, that's a little bit of confidence. You like it a little bit. And then you all, and just hope they'll just come out and play well and respond, you know, and respond, you know, and just fight.
Just what does this mean now? I mean, now that you guys have all been through this together, what does this mean now for the rest of the season and your standing and the way you feel about this race now?
Yeah, you know, honestly, we'll start dealing with that tomorrow, but I do agree with you. I think that was a big hurdle in our program, with our program. It's just having them have the ability to just keep on keeping on. You know, just don't look up at the scoreboard. Don't worry about what's happening around. Eliminate all the distractions. Keep all of the stuff around. Just stay tight. Stay tight as a team and as a unit. And just fight. And then at the end of the day, they got to believe. And they have to believe. So I think they can. I think what this allows them to do is to take some of all of the things that we've been teaching them, and really understand that it will happen that way for you. It will happen that way for you if you believe. Sometimes you teach life lessons. You teach them. It's, you know, there's disappointment after disappointment after disappointment. And then finally you get that break. And it could be monumental for you in your program. So we're hoping.
Anything else? All right, good stuff.